I'm Nina Nash-Robertson, past president of ACDA Michigan. I was born and raised in Ireland and raised on Irish dancing and singing. When I came to the U.S., of course, all my training was American, and Western, I should say, and I sought for a long time to find a body of literature that combined both of my interests and passions, the Irish music and the American and Western tradition, of which I found virtually none. And about 15 years ago, I was watching PBS, some very, very late thing of, you know, pressing buttons, and came across an Irishman speaking about choral music. The man was Michael McGlynn, and he was speaking passionately about a new body of choral literature, a new idea of Irish music brought to choirs. He is the founder and director and composer of the music for ANÚNA, which has now enjoyed great international renown. Michael's here today to share with us a multimedia presentation of his work and is joined by several singers from his choir. Topics will include an analysis of the essence of ANÚNA and how Michael's compositions relate to the indigenous music of Ireland. The session will include contributions from Seanan singer Éabha McMahon and vocalist Dónal, and we are deeply honored to welcome Michael McGlynn, Irish composer, conductor, extraordinary musician, to the ACDA National Convention. Please give him a warm welcome.
Thank you all very much for coming. It's a very special moment for me because this is the first time that Irish music in this genre has had a platform like this. We're going to begin with a short film. Because ANÚNA are not here, unfortunately, many of you will be familiar with ideas about Irish music, ideas about what you would think Irish choral music was, and often ideas even about what ANÚNA does, which are not incorrect, but they're not the full picture. So we're going to show a short film now, which is about 12 minutes long, 13 minutes long, where I talk profoundly, and you all take notes and say, I can use that later on. And you'll see some video footage. So it's really special today, and I hope that at the end you can contribute some questions as well if you have anything. So we'll begin immediately.
ANÚNA was very much created out of a love for my country, its landscape, its history, and most importantly, I think, its literature. The sense of place it gives me, it feels right for me. It feels the right place for me to live and the right place for me to create.
Thank you.
the relationship between my work and ANÚNA is something very fundamental. It's something which is at the core of my work. ANÚNA was formed originally in 1987 as a standard classical chamber choir, and then it developed into something quite unique and different in the earlier part of the 1990s. Dúlamán is a song originally from the northern part of the country, and it's a story about seaweed and seaweed gathering. The other thing that I suppose most people don't appreciate is how proud it makes me to hear my language sung by people of every colour, of every creed, of every racial background. Probably their first and maybe only exposure to the Irish language, and it's not something that they're listening to, it's something that they're participating in.
From the breeze on the mountain to the lake of deep blue, from the waterfall down to the sea, never changing or on the voice of the wind, sing the dark song of Erin to me.
The earlier works I created were created in the context of giving the audience an experience which allowed them to interact with the text and the idea of the song. So, for example, one of my best-known pieces is Sanctus from the Celtic Mass. That uses three solo voices placed in three different places, one echoing the other, and the echo is slightly different each time. And the audience are in a place where they can hear the singer behind them, they can see the singer in front of them, and they become part of the piece. They begin to think about the meaning of the text. Well, many do. Some just come and have an aural experience, and others, for example, when they hear my setting of the traditional Irish piece Jerusalem, would feel that they're having a mystical experience because the singers move around the auditorium when they sing and they envelop the audience within the sound world that they create. So the energy that the singers generate is combined in some intangible way with the energy of the audience. The music is designed for that sense of participation, for the breaking down of that wall, that barrier between the singer, the song itself, the text, and the audience. In ANÚNA, because we in many ways are all unified together, artistic vision is a shared experience. I can guide, but I'm guiding from the back line. I can tell people what the song means, but then really it's up to them to use what we would call the ANÚNA method to achieve that unification together as one community, as one unit.
Perception of what is Irish music and what is not tends to be based on ideas about Ireland, which no longer really exist in the country. Ireland is a standard European international country, like anywhere else. What it does have is an extraordinary history and an extraordinary literature and an extraordinary indigenous form of music. For many, many years, I couldn't work out myself what ANÚNA was, because although this may appear, when you look at it, to imply a type of choral music which is thriving, and there's maybe lots and lots of choirs like ANÚNA, ANÚNA is unique in Ireland. There is no other ensemble like ANÚNA. We have no connection with Irish choral music. About the middle part of the 1990s, coming up to 1998-99, America found ANÚNA in particular. And the resonance was there. So if anything, there are choirs all over America that emulate ANÚNA. So the school, maybe, of Irish choral music exists here, which is why we have this wonderful relationship together. Choral music is part of a community. The singers are a community, the audience are a community. And we work together to make the performance. There is a straight line between the ancient music of Ireland and ANÚNA. And the term for it is Seannos. Seannos is an extraordinary idea where when a singer sings, the audience and the community become involved in the idea of the transmission of the text and the meaning of the songs. So without further delay, I'm going to introduce you to Éabha and Dónal. And Éabha is a Seannos singer, as is Dónal, but I'm going to let her explain to you what the term means, take you on a little journey through where we go from there. Okay, Éabha and Dónal.
Díla Gorda. That means hello, friends. How are you? My name is Éabha McMahon, and I am a Seannos singer. I was brought up in Dublin, and I was brought up entirely through Irish. That's Gaelic, it's our national Irish language. As a very young child, I started learning Seannos because, as a tradition, you do begin learning it very young. It's our oldest form of Irish singing, and the purpose of it is to tell a story. You've probably heard a lot of traditional Irish music on the internet and on the television, but in its purest form, it is very rare. So there are a few things I will tell you about it, and then we're going to demonstrate two different styles of Seannos so that you can really get a grasp on what it is we're talking about. If you are singing a Seannos song, you cannot emote with your face. So I can't do this, I can't show you happiness with my eyes, I can't show you sadness with my body language. You must tell the story with your body, but without emoting anything. The words of the text and the line will emote the way it was written to emote. You want to be the vessel of the person who's told that story 300 years ago. You don't want to bring something new to it. Another thing is, you're not allowed to use dynamics. So if I feel that there's a sad line coming up and I know it's in Irish and you don't understand Gaelic, I can't get louder for you to know that this is a dramatic line. I can't get quieter. Another thing that you cannot do is you can't use any sort of gestures, nothing like that. So these are a couple of things with Seannos. The other thing that is highly, that's used an awful lot is ornamentation, which I'm sure you are all aware of. And in Ireland, we are in four different provinces. In the north of Ireland, you can hear a form of classical Seannos, which is a lot more melodic. It might be nicer to listen to, and a lot of the CDs that have come out of Ireland with people singing Seannos will have forms of the Ulster Seannos, which is at the top of our country. And actually, Dónal is going to be demonstrating a bit of this type of Seannos in a moment. The rest of the country sings a more ornamented style of Seannos. The line, we take it line by line. We don't really worry about where our pitch is, We're never looking at a page to see that's where you slow down, that's where you get faster. It's an entirely aural thing. So for me, I don't read music, but yet I've been at ANÚNA since I was 15 and I've been singing the most intricate pieces. I do it with my body. So I can feel where something is meant to be sung in my body. I never have to get a pitch. I can just feel it in me, and that's part of Shanna's. And I think that's really integral to how this connects to ANÚNA, because in ANÚNA, we don't have a conductor. We are one unified body of sound. We can feel each other breathing. We can feel each other singing. The pitch is a surrounding sound. I'm never thinking about myself when I'm in ANÚNA. It's one body of sound, and that is how, in my opinion, directs is related to Shanna's. So without further ado, what I'd love to show you now, because you can talk about it all you like, but until you hear it. So we're going to listen to Dónal, who is from the north of Ireland, and he sings former Shanna's, which is a little bit more melodic to the rest of Ireland. So here we go, Dónal.
Thank you, Éabha. So this song, can you all hear me okay? Any problems? So this song is from Ulster. I myself am from Ulster. And it's called Conach Las an Uair, and it is a love song talking about a man who wants to be with a lady friend, but he cannot be with her because he is going to war. And it is from the 17th century. It talks about her cheeks, the colour of her cheeks like roses, and her little shoes, and how he remembers her. And so it's called Conach Las an Uair. Er cannach las an uair as dóin ingir iad me uan, bad as dóchas imrógin is bairón as dóin siú.
So the type of Shanna's that I specialise in is the rest of Ireland. So there's the north and then there's the rest of Ireland.
Of course.
And it's a more ornamented style of Shanna's music. The song that I'm going to sing you is a song called Mórín de Barra. This is an incredibly sad song about a man that lost his love. She ran away. She didn't die. She ran away. And throughout the story, he tells about the different ways that he tried to get her back and what he would have done to get her back. But really interestingly, he never really says that until the last line. He uses picturesque things like birds and trees and the landscape to show how heartbroken he is. Yulun, the sailor, the
see choral music as something that happens and is imported. So if you go to Ireland now and you hear most contemporary Irish choral music being written, or you listen to Irish choirs, you will hear something you hear here, or you hear in Hungary, or you hear in England. And what we have tried to do is create something new while preserving something vital and ancient. We reach into the audience in a very different way to any choir I've ever seen. ANÚNA is about the interaction and the exchange of energy. Much choral music puts a barrier between the audience and the choir. The choir themselves need to create the energy. They need to form the music. And the role of the conductor is to shape that into art, not to restrain it, but to free it. So we all believe in support. We all believe in the lack of tension in the body. We all believe in the lack of tension in the face and no tension in the neck. We believe that the role of the conductor, whether they are standing there on stage, that's my usual space there, or they're standing there, is to be part of the ensemble, to free the ensemble, to create. They create the clay. The conductor is the sculptor.
You tapped into what's called Irish mouth music?
Yes, that's there is a form of music which is, it uses vocables, which is lilting. But actually, Perth of Wale is a form which comes from the Western Isles of Scotland, and that would be something like that. So that's
you incorporate it into your composition.
Yes, I do. That's a very good question. Dúlamán uses forms of Perth of Wale within it, and Himbara, as well. And in fact, a lot of the women's pieces, when they sing fast, and they're always asking me to sing fast, can we have a fast piece? We use it a lot as an inspiration, but it is not part of our tradition.
For those people who might be a little bit afraid of the program daily for their choirs, what resources do you have to help with the pronunciation? And more importantly, what does singing daily offer the choirs in terms of their vocal development, their oral development, etc.?
Well, that's a really good question. When you purchase a score from McMahon.com, you will find it comes with an IPA guide usually, or an MP3 guide. The one thing you do have to be careful about is avoid asking native Irish speakers or Irish people to help you pronounce. In Ireland, there are hundreds of dialects. So you've got to be careful. Stick to the MP3 guides you're given. What it offers a choir is that, that's a great question. In order to sing Irish properly, your face really has to be quite still and relaxed. It's a beautiful language which involves, oh my God, it just involves the jaw dropping like that. And that amazing. Oh, that's the basis for all good singing. So in ANÚNA, we very often have Americans coming in particular, and they're doing these really wide vowels, and we say to sing Irish, you need to stop singing with wide A vowels. You need to sing with your jaw down. So if anything, it's a very good workout for people that would like to expand into a different type of language. It's very singable. It's much less frightening. It uses Italianate D's and T's, and that's something that those of you that do Dúlamán might know very carefully. We don't sing Dúlamán, 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 and then we Dúlamán. Dónal has asked me just to mention the dates of the summer school, 25th, 26th, 27th of June in Dublin. And I just want to thank a couple of people very quickly. I want to thank Corey Evans. Thank you very, very much. Tim Sharp, thank you so much for having us here. And I want to thank Charles Duffy and Stacey Russell, particular of the faculty of Florida Atlantic University, who have been so amazingly helpful to me in my long journey. And there's so many of you here, I would like to thank you individually, because you've been supporting my work for decades now. And at last, I'm finding an international voice. So it's only taken me 28 years. So those of you that are young and want to compose, it takes a long time. Okay? Thank you very much.